Fire and Rain, James Taylor. When I think of the term singer-songwriter, inevitably I start to think of James Taylor and this song in particular. Beautiful song, as you all probably know, played with the capo on the third fret of the guitar like this, but I'd like to discuss it today without the capo on. Okay, so just for those of you who may not be sure, what the capo does is basically it replaces the open strings. So if I played an E chord like this, okay, without the capo, once I put the capo on now, that's the open strings, that's the nut. Okay, the capo takes the place of the nut. So if I had my E chord here without the capo, you see where the nut is in relation to my first finger, right? So same thing. This is the nut now in relation to my first finger. Okay. So if we look at the intro to Fire and Rain, we see we've got an F shape, okay? And we would be on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6th fret, 6th fret of the G string. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to make that shape, 6th fret on the G string. With an open A, right? So that's an A chord. It's the top notes of an A bar chord. All right, so we slide into it from the 3rd fret. Now, what do we have there? Okay, well, those are the top three notes of a G chord, a G bar chord, right? G, D, B. Played against an E note, that's an E minor 7. You have an E, you have a B, that's the 5th, the D is the 7th, and the G is the minor 3rd. Okay, so D, the famous James Taylor hammer-on lick, which if you've ever seen him play this, he actually does it like this somehow, and he hammers with his index finger. I find that incredibly awkward to do. I mean, I could kind of do it, but it's not for me. E chord, G major 7. Okay, those are the basic harmonic layouts of the song. Now, let's put the capo on and let's explain it this way. We're basically still playing the exact same chord shapes. We're playing what would be the open A string and an A chord, but everything has moved up three notes now because of the capo. So if we were originally in the key of A, without the capo, right? What's three notes higher than A? C. So we're now in the key of C. This are the top notes of a C bar chord. It's the exact same thing. And the reason why this open A string is now a C note is because the capo is on the 3rd fret. It's playing a C note. Okay, so if that's a C chord, went down a whole step, that's a G minor 7, right? Before we said it was an E minor 7 without the capo, we're up three notes, it's G minor 7. So we got this so far. Okay, so that, by the way, whenever you tune your guitar and then you put your capo on, you should always retune. The capo will invariably knock the guitar a little bit out of tune, the way it squeezes the strings like that. For now, let's just keep going. So we have a D chord, and then we have an A chord. But with the capo, again, we went up three notes. That's going to be an F. That's an F chord. The A chord went up three notes. That's a C chord. Why is that a C chord? Look, it's like this. Says if you played a bar chord C this way. The open string has that. Okay, so now we have this. That was an E chord, right? Well, now it's a G chord. Why? Because of that. It's a G chord, bar chord shape. The capo's doing it. We had a G major 7. That's a 3 notes higher. Right there is your root. That's a B flat. B flat major 7. Okay. And then just really quickly through the chorus, you've got... Okay, the D shape, but that's an F chord. So you have this. So we're playing this descending line, F, E over, or actually it's F over E, D minor 7, G sus, C, all right? So, again. B flat. Okay, so what are we getting there? We got the open A string, which is a C note. This are the top notes of a B flat major bar chord. So you have B flat over C. And that C acts like a 5 chord. Going to the F chord. Hope you enjoyed today's breakdown. If you did, please consider subscribing to my channel for more videos like this to come. And thank you for watching.